Welcome back, everybody. Joshua Franco is here, the reigning, the defending WBA super flyweight world champion, who's looking to repeat what he pulled off in June, which was a major upset of Andrew Moloney. This time, I don't know what the odds are, but it's probably pretty close, so it wouldn't be as big of an upset this time around. So from San Antonio, Texas, Joshua Franco joining us here. Joshua, how are you, sir?
Good, good. How are you?
Great, great. So before we get to the questions, and again, for questions, raise hand button, message in the chat below, or if you can't figure those out, just shoot me a text and I will get you in the queue. So Joshua, it's been, what, 4 months, 5 months since you shocked a lot of people inside the bubble. How much of an advantage of it is it now coming back to the bubble, having experienced that the first time and knowing what to expect in that environment?
Yeah, I think it's a good advantage just because, you know, I've been in there before. I've experienced it, and I know how it is to be in the bubble.
Yeah, no, it's obviously it's a certainly unique atmosphere. So we will get started with the questions. Gaz Singh from Behind the Gloves. Gaz, please unmute and ask your question.
Hey, Joshua. Nice to speak to you. Basically, in the first fight, you threw 40 more punches overall than Moloney did, and that played a factor in you taking a belt from him. Do you think that your work rate is going to be one of the keys to victory in this rematch?
Of course. I could you know, slow down my work rate, or I could pick it up, you know, whenever I want to. And, you know, I just feel like that's going to be an advantage for sure.
Thanks, dude.
Thank you.
Sorry for the delay, guys. Next up, we go to Southern California with Miguel Maravilla. Miguel, please go ahead when ready.
Hey, Josh, how's it going? First of all, man, how's the confidence coming into this second fight? We knew the first fight was going to be a tough one for you. It was going to be, you know, quite a fight to get that world title. How do you feel coming into the second fight, you and Robert?
I feel very confident just because I've been in the ring with Andrew Moloney before. I know what he has. I'm always confident. And of course, you know, my training went well. I had a tough training camp, and, you know, that also brings my confidence up. So, you know, I'm just ready for whatever.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Miguel. And now we go ahead to J.R. Bell. J.R., please go ahead when ready.
All right there. Following up on the question about work rate, there was the other thing in this fight where it seemed like you were able to take the punches there from Andrew Moloney. So going into that, do you feel like you are confident that you could, you know, take what Moloney can give and just bring it right back like you did in the first fight?
Of course. You know, I took his best punches in the fight, and I, you know, I mean, I know what he has. So, I mean, to me, I didn't feel much from him. So, you know, I mean, I'm very confident, and, you know, I just feel like my work rate is going to take over, and, you know, I'm going to start from the beginning.
All right. Thank you very much. And now let's see who else we have in the queue. Jason from Fight View 360 over in Australia. Jason, please go ahead when ready.
Hey, thanks, Evan. Yeah, g'day, Josh, mate. First of all, congratulations on the win, mate, even though you beat an Aussie. Mate, has anything changed for your preparation for this fight, for the last fight? And I'll also ask the same question I asked Andrew. If things don't go your way on Saturday night, would you be interested in the trilogy?
I'm sorry. What was that again? I lost you right there. I'm sorry.
Sorry, mate. Has anything changed for your preparation from the last fight to this fight? And if things don't go your way on Saturday night, obviously I'm hoping they don't because I'm an Aussie. Would you be interested in the trilogy?
Nothing's changed, you know, for this fighting camp. You know, I'm always training hard. The only thing I would say is I got tougher sparring for this fight. And, you know, just and if, you know, things don't go my way, I'm not even thinking about that. But if they don't, then maybe the trilogy. I mean, who knows? We'll see what happens. You know, I've been there before, so why not? But it's not going to happen.
Oh, we'll see Saturday night, mate. Good on you.
Thank you very much, Jason. And now we go back to Carlos Toro. Carlos, please go ahead when ready.
Hey, Joshua. Thanks so much for taking time to talk to us. You know, you're no stranger to preparing and fighting in rematches. You got the trilogy against Oscar Negrete that ended last year. So when it comes to preparing for a rematch, in terms of approaching it from a game plan standpoint, do you change anything as far as seeing what can be done differently in this fight, even though you were victorious? Because even though you're more familiar with Andrew, the same could be said, you know, vice versa. And do you feel like you kind of rely more on the winning game plan other than besides, you know, adjusting to different things that he might do differently?
Well, I'm just very prepared for anything he brings. You know, when, you know, like you said, I have the trilogy under my belt, but I mean, they're both different fighters. And, you know, I just feel like, you know, once I get in the ring, I'm going to just make my adjustments and, you know, just do what I have to do.
Thank you, Joshua. Best of luck on Saturday.
Thank you.
Sorry about that, guys. Next, we go over to Shane Dyer from the UK. Shane, please go ahead when ready.
Thank you, Evan. Hello, Josh. Shane here for Boxing Social.
How's it going?
A win on Saturday could potentially open up a few big fights for yourself, considering looking at the other world champions at your division. Has that been on your mind at all since you've become world champion?
Of course. It's been on my mind before I even became world champion. Now that I'm world champion, you know, even more, you know, I'm right there to, you know, for the bigger fights. And, you know, a win on Saturday night will open up, you know, big doors for me, and I know it's going to happen.
Awesome. Thanks, Josh.
Thank you very much, Shane. And now we have a couple questions from Keith Idek from Boxing Scene. Keith, you should be unmuted and go ahead when ready.
Hey, Joshua. How is winning a world title, particularly after everything you went through in the previous 2 years between getting, you know, losing by TKO and then the two draws with Negrete, how has it changed your life and what has it been like for you the last few months?
Oh, yeah, it changed my life a lot. You know, like you said, those past 2 years that I had, you know, I had my ups and downs, you know, but now that I'm a world champion, I'm in the talks with big names, you know, Chocolatito, Gallo Serrada, German and Cajas, you know, all of those top guys, you know, and, you know, it's just a dream come true.
From a personal perspective, what has it been like, you know, down there in San Antonio? I know it's a town with rich boxing history and everything. What has that been like for you?
It's been good, you know, a lot more respect, you know, to be one of the few world champions in San Antonio. It means a lot. And, you know, just coming from a boxing city like San Antonio is just great.
I know Mario Barrios beat you to the punch a little bit a couple of days ago last week when he became the first from San Antonio to defend the title. But what would it mean to kind of, you know, to become at least the second one to do that?
It would mean everything, you know. I mean, just another history mark for San Antonio and for me as well.
What did you think of the – I know you're in a fight, so I guess all's well that ends well. But what did you think of the scoring, being that the knockdown was the difference on two of the cards and, you know, you were a knockdown away from it being a majority draw?
Yeah, I mean, it was kind of crazy. I felt like I dominated more than, you know, the scorecard said. And, I mean, what can I do? You know, I mean, it wasn't up to me. You know, the judges chose that, but this time I'll make sure it's different.
Meaning that you'll try to get him out of there more, or what do you mean by that?
Just make the win more clear. I mean, if the knockout comes, then it comes. But if not, then I'm going to dominate all 12 rounds.
Thank you, Joshua.
Thank you.
Thank you, Keith. And next we go to Ernesto Amador. Ernesto, please unmute and go ahead.
Hello, dear Joshua. It's not a question. It's something that you have on your back. You have millions of Mexicans behind you. What is the meaning for you? And if you can practice not only your English, but your Spanish too. So if you can tell me what is the meaning for you to have millions of Mexicans behind you in English and Spanish, please. Thank you.
Yeah, it means a lot. You know, just it motivates me more, you know, just to have that blood, have you know, the Mexican support behind me. It means a lot, you know. my family's from Mexico, so I mean, you know, I have a lot of support in from Mexico as well, and Zacatecas, they support me over there. So, you know, I appreciate all the support.
How about Spanish,
please? I can't translate in Spanish.
Well, just a little.
I don't know.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Ernesto, and we go back to the UK. Jonathan Nagoff. Jonathan from Pro Boxing Fans in the UK. Please unmute and go ahead when ready.
Hey, Josh. In the first fight, you went in as the underdog. What's the mentality like now, having defied the odds and won the fight? How are you approaching this fight mentally going into the second fight? And secondly, from the UK, I know you've mentioned before about a possible fight with Charlie Edwards. Is that something that still interests you, should you be successful?
Mentally, I'm going to this fight very confident. You know, I'm the world champion for a reason, and I'm going to stay world champion. You know, I'm still learning, and, you know, each day in the gym, I'm learning more. So, I mean, I know I'm going to win Saturday night. And, you know, fight with Charlie Edwards, you know, we'll see what happens in the future.
Best of luck.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much, Jonathan. Again, as a reminder, raise hands, send a private message, or shoot me a text, and we will get to as many questions as possible. So we got a few more minutes with Josh. So anybody wants to ask a question to Josh, please go ahead when ready. So I'm just going to take a look at the chat queue here. Okay, looks like Miguel Maravilla has another question. So Miguel, please go ahead. Miguel, you're unmuted, so please ask your question when ready.
Hey, Joshua, you mentioned that the first time around, you know, you scored the knockdown, but the scorecards were still close. Do you feel that this time around you're going to need to put more pressure? You're going to have to, you know, win more convincingly?
Of course. I mean, yeah, that's, you know, that's the mindset I have going into this fight.
What's the preparation been like with you and Robert?
You know, very tough preparation in the gym, you know. Eight hard weeks of training, and you know, I'm ready, more than ready.
Is the plan basically the same as the last time, put pressure on the guy?
I mean, we'll see what happens in the fight. You know, I'll make my adjustments. I am the better fighter. I mean, so I'm just looking for the win on Saturday night.
Thank you very much. So before we go, Joshua, I mean, is there anything you haven't told the boxer?
So there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Seckbach reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, at Seckbach. And you can follow me on Instagram, at Elie Seckbach.